Okay, welcome to Awakening the Chess Fight to Five. I'm your commentator Kishi, and my co-commentator is.
It's me, Rezil. We don't have a tournament today, so Awakening the Gear is not happening. Instead of that, we seemingly have a few show matches. They will be first to five. I don't know how many we have. I think it's two or four, depending on how our host is trying to format that. Whatever, we will be informed of that really soon. So, the four players are WV Vladimir. I saw this guy earlier in the in the, what was so common in the floor things, like the celestial floor thing, is he's a Zato, if I remember correctly. Yuki CHR, I don't know who that is. Same with Xalcris. And the last player, that's actually an interesting one, Exe. Is that the Exe from BB Tag?
I guess.
Because, no. I remember this guy pretty well for having a really unhealthy attitude about himself.
Can you not bring this up right now?
What did he say?
I mean, we not shall talk about past like this. Probably.
He was a pretty good nine. He just had like a bit of an unhealthy attitude to his own play. You know, these kind of players who are kind of down on themselves all the time.
Yeah, I remember.
I think he left in 1.3 or something like that. Then I didn't see him again. What a shame though. Also, like I said, he had like a pretty good nine. I don't remember who else he played. Okay. Well, anyway, new game.
Welcome. I should join you.
Uni release. Right. I remember you switched to uni. That was like, I even met you in uni at some point, but I didn't continue to play that, so. Okay, let me see how you do here. It's like I'm excited to see what character you play. I'm not sure what a nine player would play in this game.
He plays a lot of chars. Like
in Guild Gear?
He played Izayoi, he played Carmine.
And then do you know about Guild Gear?
And Guild Gear, I don't know. No idea.
Are we gonna see? It's like, the stream room is open. Let me get into there. Do we have a keyboard already?
Yes, in Tournament channel.
Ah, okay, Tournament. Okay, no stuff. There it is. Man, they said that go faster, but that shit still takes forever. And W.
I still use Totsugeki for it. I think it's actually made Totsugeki faster to use.
Totsugeki is like, if I understood correctly, just reading the cache, right? So. That should be power for the course. Okay, which one do we go for this year? Okay.
So we have our both players.
Let's see who's gonna play.
Who is first to play?
I don't know. Mr. Organizer, inform us. Are we doing just two first to fives, or are we just doing everyone against everyone so that everyone plays against everyone one time in the first to five? If the latter, I just count the score by round number, I guess.
So we have first is Vladimir, which is Zato player with color. It seems scary.
Color, it's like he has one of those auras.
Yeah.
Ah yes, like that's the, I think that was like the players who did well, who did play enough in Celestial to not get downranked, right? After the month ends, or something like that.
I thought it sounds like we just played a lot.
I mean, generally the ranking system in how as a whole Celestial is ranked, and the ranking system is generally more about how much you play than about how good you play, because it only counts wins.
Yeah, but still.
Yeah, but still, yeah. Like, I mean, if you play a lot, you more or less will get better, right?
Of course.
Sometimes there are like in these news, there are some people like most matches won that day, 900 and so something. How do you play that many matches in a day? It's like.
Yeah.
Okay, Yuki CHR, Giovanna against our Zato. Let's see how he does. Zato, I think Zato is really scary. Yeah, it was before the patch and even more so now.
What was wait. Is it crashed?
Yeah, it crashed.
Okay.
The classic.
Yeah. Us.
Oh, pain. It just doesn't work. Okay, what do we have now? Oh, the Anji, an Anji. Level 13 Anji. Okay, pretty new to the game it seems, or at least pretty new to the character. I think to get level 13 you have to win like twice. And immediately finds himself in the Zato Eddie cross-up, basically, like sandwich. Eats the over it.
You need to be. To defend against Zato, you either need to be quite good and in understanding his tools, or just not trying to, but just not to block him at all in first place.
Yeah, it's like if you want to deal with Zato pressure, you kind of have to know the matchup. If you don't, he just runs you over more or less. Once you start blocking, that is. Oh, okay, 2K sweep. Okay.
Oh no, it's gonna be. Yeah, it's dead. Oh, if. If wall splat was slightly less, Salah would die before it.
Oh, with that? 1-0 to Mr. Vladimir.
Yes, wait, opponent. Again, this. Oh, he whipped, but.
Oh, eats the frog. I can feel that. It's like I ate. Oh, another frog.
It's very much. Honestly.
I feel the spin, yeah. It happens to me so often still to me that I get hit by the frog just randomly.
Yeah. I played this game for like 300 house, and I can't say whether I can defend against that at all.
So it's not only that you have to. That you really have to know what you're doing. Zato is not a commonly played character, so getting practice is not that easy.
Vladimir plays quite well. He even baited the boss after this grab and pause. How would you call like this move, which becomes from wall to damage? Not wall.
I mean wall splat.
The
wall break.
No, I mean. Okay, whatever. Let's forget about it.
Okay. Another wall break. Is on positive bonus. Eddie not available. Okay.
You really can just let this block this frog like this. You need to contest in some way, like 6P for example.
Does 6P even work against the frog?
Yes, well, like...
I don't think so, to be honest.
It depends on when you dance and from which distance, but you can shoot, no, well, maybe not 6P, but any 5P, for example. Like when frog goes into highest hit and before it starts fall down again.
I mean that's probably not that good of an idea because when the frog comes, Zato will approach behind him and he will very likely sweep you behind it. So, in worst case, you're gonna eat a sweep counter hit. So, I don't know if that's a good idea actually. But I guess better than trying to block it. It's like Mr. Vladimir right now isn't even doing that fancy stuff. It's like the common, it's like very very common Zato pressure, but it worked very well for him. So, Mr. Was that best of the button that only 3 rounds right now?
Yes, I believe it was 3-0. But honestly, it was quite missed much. Unfortunately.
Oh, okay, you definitely thought it was 1st of 3.
Yeah.
Like
tournament, yes.
I mean, common mistake, can happen. No problem. Oh. Oh, Ronan says 6P works against Frog, yes. Depends if you're a negative edge leap or a leap special in pit. Also, Zato doesn't really get good reward out of punishing you killing leap with 6P. Boss, I know.
Well, I think so too. Because even if he will hit you in recovery for 6P, it will not be counter hit. So, and he can actually use any specials into combo from normal besides Eddie's, how is what move called, to 6P, like with low hit move. Do you get what I mean, Rezi?
Yeah, I saw you. I thought you were addressing Robin. I know what you mean. Well, if you kill the frog, there's nothing to follow up with. Yes, sure. Are they continuing? Let me check chat.
Seems we're going to play next match.
Okay, so. Seems like he forfeit, so I add that to 5 on Vladimir's count.
Can we actually call this match, like, I guess yes, it matches, not to casual matches, something like this.
Okay, seems like another match by Mr. Vladimir against Yuki this time, the one that got disconnected in the first time. Let's see if it works now.
Yes.
Okay.
Giovanna versus Zato. I never saw this matchup, honestly.
To be honest, me neither. I mean, have not seen that.
It's a lot of characters, honestly.
Okay. I mean, it's... Ooh. It's mostly since you see Zato
jump. Oh, he actually jumped that Devil jump.
Oh, nice.
He again jumped after plus frames. Yuki need to use more faster move to catch his jumping. Oh, it's that.
Nobody can hold his auto pressure.
Yep.
No offense though, I wouldn't either. I would have died there too, very likely. Okay.
Oh, nice contest. Okay.
Oh, that was a dangerous whip on the 214K. Oh, nice sweep.
Nice. Fortunate. He tried to just miss, but... And now it's Zato time for pressure.
I think Gio should be have a good time contesting that, actually, because I don't think Zato can advance very far behind Eddie. When Gio does her very, very balanced sweep. What got her anyway, 1A for Mr. Vladimir. Okay, get immediately with the spiral arrow.
Yeah.
No shit's given.
It's just a choice. This move, diving upward kick is minus 4 on block, so you can actually do it.
You still sometimes have to respect it, since she could very well just DP afterwards.
Yeah, it's in this version DP is actually much kinda new on ground, so you can more or less contest it like with something. Like, for example, 6p.
Yeah, sure, but with that you have to read the... For that you have to read the actual attempt for DDP. So it's still dangerous. It's not completely... Oh! Okay, ooh! Hit through the armor! And with that, goes out a second time. And Vladimir takes...
Likes this setup into this 12 4p. From Eddie into grab. If I remember correctly, it should give massive damage if walls damage wall. If not for wall.
I mean, it does quite a bit, which is surprising considering that throws are rotated to 50 by default in this game, if I remember correctly. So. It's still that he still does this much damage out of it is quite surprising, to be honest. Okay.
Can he kill it? Oh no. I wonder if he could do it with RC. He probably should. Again.
Okay. Gets a
slow move. Oh.
Gets the sandwich set up into overhead. Oh, immediately gets sweeped on wake up.
Oh, contested. Will Yuki block? Yeah, it's also plus on block, so it's actually quite good in neutral with super. Block didn't hit for second time, so wasn't couldn't.
Didn't take the confirm there. Okay.
Nothing.
Okay.
Wait.
There was no reverse.
It's about to come back to the... Yeah. Yuki's pressures is just too simple. I believe he never tried to go for a grab after close slash. What do you want to say?
I mean, yes, I mean, it's fairly. I mean, all the openers he got, like all the openers he confirmed at least, were jump ins and 1-2k in 1-2k. I think more it's going into a continuous pressure that is, even if it's very simple with Geo, is not ineffective, I think, but what like saying sprung out more in this match, in the last matchup, was that he was visibly afraid of Zato, and stopped, backdashed, and just let him get his game rolling again. That is, yeah. Oh, we have a soul. Exe!
Yeah.
With the soul. Society. Okay.
So instead of reflecting on themselves, interesting.
People might disagree with you. I actually like quite like watching soul players. Because really? I think here Soul has some really fucking cool conversions. And he's generally, it's like the only thing I really, really dislike. Gets the. Oh, super through. We'll get the Oki.
Yeah.
Oh, okay, almost. Almost fucked it up. And, okay, nice to that. What I want to say is, like, there's only two things I like. Of course, his damage output is very silly. And his 5k is a war crime. And he shouldn't have a command grab, in my opinion, but so it makes Soul really jarring to play against him, but watching Soul is cool. Okay, so cool. Nice revolver.
Finally got in, and Vladimir immediately give. That's ERC. Okay.
It's the 6H. Didn't confirm with the Night Raid Vortex.
Yeah, it's also unfortunate, but it's still... Vladimir is like one hit from death.
Okay. Blocks that, goes with the JS.
Again, yes. I wonder if he actually will adjust to it at some point.
The 5k is actually quick enough to jump into this.
It's like button into dust is something like usually frame trap for most char, but not against pre-frame normal.
Yeah, it's like Soul is very privileged when it comes to that with his okay. Oh, nice! Just landed on the
actual punish, but Vladimir tried to probably something do after this. Nice. What's gonna be
another
again? Oh.
OTG 6H and takes out the Zato.
That was very impressive. Finally someone stopped Vladimir from running everyone over.
XC.
Oh, okay. Nice. He catched 80, but
oh, you actually can sweep Soul out of Bandit Revolver, that's interesting. Oh, Nitrate Vortex into the armor, gets frogged on, converted, and that's gonna hurt a lot. Immediate
title grab. Which, understandable. Wait, was it combo? No.
That was not a combo. He reset him.
I see.
Oh, that Eddie whiffed completely. He respected it anyway. Takes again distance. Okay, this runs in.
Oh, nice. Him.
Can't hold the armor. I'm surprised he didn't hold Frey instead, but okay. Revolver, yes. Red cancel. Nice bait. Ooh. Nice out of the corner. Wake up grab, getting him into a command grip.
actually want to go for more greedy play instead of meaty after grab.
5k.
Yep.
And with that, he's out. Red dead. That's not real against my boy Soul. 6h round start. The classic I win round start button.
Yeah. Vladimir finally jump up. And again, catched here.
Ben Fafnir?
Oh. He probably tried to get his troll on wake up. With this save. Is this 6H? I guess.
6H is the one he did on. So. Oh, okay. Gets out the armor again. The drills. He wanted that 2-1-4K there.
Nice.
And sweeps him out with that. second round goes to
So for 6S on Vaiko, it was quite ballsy. And Vladimir just meaty with some close to it. Okay.
Try to back that. That's not gonna work.
Yes. And he managed to also bite burst.
Okay, it's far slashed on.
This four actually gives so much time to get to hit confirm.
Okay, come on, grab. Is that death?
No, it's not. Oh, it's actually death, yeah.
Bandit Bringer, immediate. Oh, feints the gun flame.
Well,
Didn't go as planned. I think he just didn't get the follow-up he wanted there too. Contests some in the air. Gunflame POC!
Again. That place loves VXC. For good reasons. Because, like, aside from my from jab, we don't really have much defense at all.
Okay, got baited. Got taken out. Another one to Mr. Vladimir.
It's 3-1 for Vladimir here.
Yes, I need 2-1.
2-1?
I think. Yeah, 2-1. It's 2-1.
Okay.
Oh, nice tag on the airframe. Kicks away the Eddie.
Good. Oh, immediate burst. Interesting. Gonna be a car.
Again with the over.
What's gonna be okay from Vladimir?
Just
grab.
Come on, grab. Oh, that actually killed.
Yes, and I think he actually tried to DP, otherwise I don't know why it was punished.
Oh, okay. Instant block by Mr. SC, but wasn't enough.
Ready.
Oh, whiff stun bro. What's a... That's a few pixels too far away for that.
Okay. Well, so annoying.
Neutral jump and
Nice
vortex under it. Nice reaction there from XE. Goes in. That's not gonna work. Oh, he pressed something. No,
he didn't press. He was just running forward. He probably wanted to run forward and do something like... grab, I guess.
I mean, I think the correct answer would have been Tyrant Flamme, right? That should have worked, I guess. I mean, still could have clashed, so I don't know. That was ballsy to press a button there,
yeah,
but it worked out.
I would say that would be better, but maybe it was some big brain move which I don't really understand. Okay. Nice! Almost
got
his confirm,
unfortunately. OTG'd. PSC into double overhead. Wild throw down.
And Zato actually died. Nice.
Why does Wild throw do so much damage? I don't understand. I think he shouldn't have it in the first place, like, and then it does so much damage. Oh, try to do it again. Was a bit too far away. 6P? Look at that 6P conversion. Yeah. On courtesy of 1.10. He got knocked down there.
It should be fine. And okay, he did FD only when got hit. Let's talk about this. Can he heal? No. I'm going to actually press button. It was very finicky situation. Like Vladimir usually gold burst is minus 10, but it was air hit, so maybe Vladimir actually was plus. I'm not sure.
Oh, Brock gets
okay.
Nice. Eats the Eddie sweep. 2-1-4 and gets anti
air. Vladimir actually managed to catch this body bringer.
Come on,
he goes for frog and he got he got Ingrid Frog. Depth.
Depth, yeah.
Two.
It's important to understand that that was like plus 7 after this command grab on Oki. So you can actually contest AD stuff.
Nice Fender Banger.
It's unfortunate.
Whiffs the jumping slash, gets hit by the frog, and super. On absolute life support now, Mr. Axie. Backward Blue RC, good idea, but underestimated the range of the Eddie. With that, goes down. And 4-2. Yeah, again, just walked up, thrown him.
Oh! Exe actually had a good idea, but he jumped, unfortunately.
Frog.
Oh! He catched him. And now he's going to run. Nine. Damn it.
Okay, just grab. Wake up, grab, gets hit by that backdash.
Ooh. Oh wow! I actually thought he was in whiff animation, but he actually was in startup animation. So,
I also thought he would have whiffed the throw or something there, but I guess cheeky animation startup. Okay, two slash hits, no conversion into block string into command grip. We'll get the Oki.
Yes, this time go for spammy.
Has lost the chill, just pressing slash directly into his pockets, reset into wild throw, and takes out his auto.
Yeah, it was great reset actually.
Oh, 5k, gets him.
Will he try? Oh, he tried. He actually thought Vladimir will do something.
There's, oh, okay. Okay, the JS is him. Sword. Oh, Night Raid Vortex under that. That was a nice reaction on that. Air throw, nice. Takes him out. And with that, we go to 3-4.
Duel 1. Let's rock.
6H, okay. Oh, backdash, fall slash, okay. Just lets him recover, takes the afro. Okay. Zato in the corner now. Pinko C, 6p, goes it. Drop the combo there though. Or, that could have been actually intentional to keep the corner. I don't think the combo would have killed anyway, since no meter was available.
Of course.
Okay, there's the star. Nice. Gets the
and the super good, but he got nothing from this. So
gets ooh, 60.
Nice.
Next, we immediately goes in with the JSJD, or no, I think that was JPJD. In the corner now, has to deal with this auto pressure now. Who has done? Tries to go again for the counter, it's after the pokes, but didn't work out for him this time. Nice. Super, that's gonna cost. Oh!
Oh! Yes, because it's actually quite a lot of time after Super Flash, like 10 frames or so. Nice.
Got the second hit of the okay. Another another raw super. He really likes you there. Just say ages him out of there. Oh no! Runs off, grabs him, and with that. That could be the last rain for Mr. Exe, if he's in careful. Oh,
okay.
No, another one. Backdash. Oh.
He actually converted into wall break. Nice.
Gets poked on. Two slash hits, no conversion. Oh, okay, we're both just throwing. 2k, 2d hits him with the 2d combat. Ooh, just jumps into the armor.
It was Vladimir could my boss. Oh!
Run under.
Wow.
Heavy slash DP there. Quite a soul maneuver. And takes it to the final round.
Yes.
Oh, Banderbringer hitting the Zato. Ooh, what? Oh,
wow. Okay. That was an interesting choice.
Okay. Ooh, just jumps out of there. Banderbringer. Doesn't care about that. He's good. He's really good with those airframes.
Vladimir's defense is mostly jumping. So it's quite good to read. Reliable read to try.
Okay. Tries to go for the 2 slash again. Oh, hits into the armor. Gets 2 slash on again. Oh, 5k, yes. Can't convert with an RC, the meter isn't there. Jumps, revolver, ooh. Cheeky attempt, and actually converts out of that 5k and takes the terrain.
Yeah, he converted only after one hit through 5k. Nice.
Kills the Eddie not available. Gets 6 slashed on. Oh, nice conversion into the Nightwave Vortex. 2 slash, 2 slash. Oh, okay. Lost a bit of grip on the pressure there. Or just runs in, grabs him. Oh, yeah. Mr. Vladimir. In danger here. Now it's his potential last game.
He probably could actually kill Jet if he gone for follow-up kick into wall break. But he decided to kill for sure with his reset.
And with that, Mr. Axi takes the set as the winner of this first 2-5.
Yes. Hello, that was quite roller coaster of set, honestly. Like first it was 4-1 for Vladimir, or 4-2 for Vladimir. Was it like this?
What? No, it's 4-5.
No, before, like at some point.
Ah, it was, I think, 3-1, and then it turned around.
Okay, let's actually check our chat.
Okay, yeah. So, I think Mr. Vladimir has played against everyone that is here now.
Yes.
Salcross with Yuki. Okay. I think these were the two more newer players to the game that we had here. So, let's see how they do. Anji against Giovanna.
Mankind knew that they cannot change society. Duel 1.
Oh, dash in 2k, no confirm. Just poking at each other. Oh, spider arrows in. No better. Oh, careful, his own health and safety there. Through the wall with the 2k, 2-1-4k. Oh, dashes in. Bit of indecisiveness there on Yuki's part. Maybe thought he would parry or something, but there was no meter anyway, so. Okay, backdash, false dash, okay, what's happening?
Wait, backdash? Are you sure? It was grab in the end for me.
It's desync for me.
Wow. See?
I have two bots playing against each other.
What? Two bots?
Yeah, it's like they're just... this game, man.
Wait. Okay, let's... I think I'm watching correct match. Yes.
Emily, you have to check basically if what you are watching is the same that goes on stream.
You're right. Seems so far it's fitting. And Yuki takes the first game. Okay. Should you think right now, Yen?
I got kicked.
Wow.
I'm in the lead.
DP for Lander? No, it's not DP. It's DP for 6 S or something. I don't remember notation for this move, but it's core.
Ooh, yeah. It's one of the best anti-airs in the game, in my opinion. It has such a generous hitbox.
Yes, absolutely, and very good reward, usually.
Yeah, that too. And you can basically do it just like immediately out of a parry attempt, so it's quite a good move.
Yes.
He just... right? Oh.
Yuki actually really likes this plus jumping move. 236 H, I believe. Like
it's 236. It's 236 S.
Oh, I see. And people stop playing.
I mean, yes, because I have to get in again.
Oh.
If they continue, I won't be able to see it.
Well, that's right, but did we actually listen to us to do such decision?
I don't know. I just follow what's happening on screen at this point.
Oh, it's because Xylax has decided to switch to his character.
Oh, okay, I think Mr. Xy misunderstood that and took over for him. I guess then we are watching Xy against Yuki now. Oh no, it's Xalras. With Sol, I immediately thought it would be Xy.
I did set for his kitchen.
I didn't think about that somebody would... So much damage out of 3 hits. Oh, yeah, gets the 3k, converts to Nitrate Vortex, okay.
Yes.
Just slams him down.
Since Xalras actually had some conversions for Sol in comparison to Angie. Or I guess Nitrate Vortex is easy to do, maybe. I don't know, I never played Sol.
I played Sol for a bit, like Nitrate Vortex conversions are... aren't that hard, to be honest, but you need a good starter for it. It's like you need like a level 3 counter to it, otherwise it won't work. You will still get the hit otherwise, but it will most likely OTG. Okay. Get some Nightred Vortex, okay, did punish it. That is punishable, Mr. Yuki. Just 2k, 214k is your answer there. Huh?
Oh! Yuki tried to do grab on Jacob, but Xalax did 5p. Yes. Again, 5p.
The meaties are not on point here. Gets the 5p on Wake Up.
And Xalax got his first game.
Okay. 56p on model wall Nitrate Vortex. Oh, try to double Nitrate. That's not gonna work. 6h would have worked then. Okay, just lets him do the full. Just goes with the full auto combo there on the Geo. That's dangerous.
Again, Nitrate Vortex. you can actually block, but he didn't punish. That's unfortunate. And it was Wild Ghost. Again, 5p. And again, Vortex. Wild game.
Don't let him do that. Don't let him get away with this. Oh, Bandit Bringer. Okay.
Okay, this time he got Mitty.
Process. Okay, oh, just 6 piece out of there. Oh, this time gets the Meaty and Frozen Tool. That super would have killed there.
Get, oh my god. Almost. He almost got good conversion on me.
Oh god.
Was it? Is it popping into Vortex combo?
Yeah, you can pop me into Vortex, but yeah, like, that's possible.
Wow. Okay.
But it needs to counter it though. Otherwise, it OTGs.
Oh, I see. Makes sense.
Ah, this. Oh, this is, yeah, he has found the solution. Don't let him do anything. He hasn't found the DP block yet.
Sweet. Wow.
Oh. Okay, 6H. Nightmare Vortex. Yeah, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, so we're
super. Do you do FC? Oh, please. Please, oh, you, please.
I mean,
that was actually kind of interesting footsies. Like 214k with punish.
That's what we call baited. I mean, both of these players seem to be pretty new, so I think for like what level 50-56, the Geo isn't as bad. The soul is lacking conversions. It's like, ooh, okay.
After his fire slash,
he seems to have like basic understanding on how the conversions for soul are supposed to work, but there's a bit a visible lack of progress there. Okay, god, nice reaction. Just punish the
slow.
And another rough of you. Fafnir is such a cool move though too. It's like he just swings really hard at you. I like that.
Yep.
Oh nice. Guts already.
Wow.
Ah, Fafnir.
Sweep after Fafnir. What is this game?
Okay. Okay, gets the Nightwave Vortex. Ooh, that was very gambly there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, does not extend by 2k and
try to grab, and he also whiffed his grab. So even if it wasn't 5p from Sol from Xanrax, then he would actually still die.
Yeah, that was like whiff grabs have quite the recovery in this game. Okay, it's okay.
Oh.
Another, okay. Yeah. Oh, full auto combo, that's so dangerous on block.
Yeah.
Okay. Almost fully converts that. He wanted the 2H there, but did get the fast slash instead to. And lost the conversion.
Awesome.
Oh, nice! Oh, if that was intentional, I really like that. That is the Whiff 236S close slash. It's like I certainly have a friend who started playing the game with Geo2. He does shit like this on purpose. I really like that because it catches me off guard, because I would never expect that. Okay, 214. YSC? Okay, blocks the.
Yeah, probably he should block this, but it's fine.
Oh, okay. Both players did DP.
The show of force on both sides. Oh!
Oh my god, what is this? Geo was super. It was something
else. I actually wasn't sure what would win there, the Banditbringer or the Geo Super.
Yeah, Banditbringer was just too high. What? Shot Island, right? Wow. Again.
Oh, okay.
It was almost conversion.
I'm surprised that Mr. Salcross doesn't do the online cam with Sol.
Oh, what is it?
The online cam. There's like, you know, like in Street Fighter, I can't do Tatsu into DP a lot. And you can do this, the equivalent of this in Guilty Gear Strive is Soul players doing Bandit Bringer into SDP.
Hmm. See.
Oh, okay. Okay. Gets you, another. Okay. Gets bursted on.
You can just bite, block Vortex and punish it.
Okay.
I wonder if he could kill this super.
Yeah, he could have killed the super. The but generally, I think Yuki is not. Yuki is, I think, not comfortable with the input for Venezia or something like that because he just doesn't use it at all. Even though it's like since the last patch, Venezia was buffed so fucking hard. The damage on that increased so harshly.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
To the point where it's from some openers, just going button into Venezia is optimal. That is not often the case though, but it speaks for how harsh the move was increased, but I don't even know if it was this flat damage that was improved or the scaling, I don't know. But it does a lot of damage now. I'm surprised that Nitrate Vortex trades with Spiral Arrow instead of just straight up beating it.
I mean, I guess we had both at close around same time, active time, something.
Okay.
Mitty? Oh, what? It was such a good move to 6S.
Oh,
please, you can punish it! Don't let a Soul player bully you like that.
Okay. Oh, another one!
And he will do it again! And yeah. he will get again!
Oh, Gunflame this time? Oh, just goes through with it with the projectile iframes off Spiral Arrow. Get a good reaction on that.
I've learned about this armor things against Project only quite late actually. I didn't know Javan has armor against projectile on this move until very late.
Oh, it's like yeah. I learned that the hard way. I mean, you play Mulya's, like you have projectiles, but those are not contestable really because they're just too fast.
Yeah.
I mean, the S version is too fast and the H version lingers way too hard to get through it for Giovanna, so. And furthermore, like, why would you ever contest it as Giovanna? Since if Emilia is doing one of her rings, she will be above it. So there's no point in playing a ring under that.
You're just going. But mostly, yeah, it's not good to contest this. And it seems like Silex is on match point right now. On set point.
Set point. Last set. So set point is one round away. It seems. Okay. No punch on that burst. Jumps in. Okay. Gives him the heal. Whoop. Just nice.
Oh, actually, just he's for. I'm gonna hit low to get him out of it. Good idea. If I assume Yuki just doesn't know, but it's very punishable on block.
Yeah. For Geo, that Geo can just 2k, 2-1, 4k afterwards. With the red cancer, she can get quite a good punish out of all for Nitrate Vortex and block. So, that's set point for now for Cypress.
Oh, it's always painful to see. Again, and I wonder what Yuki tries to do to press against it.
I think it's close slash, but he's too late.
Wait, what?
That works.
Did he on Super Flash?
I would have assumed that clashes, but I guess the Soul is just too privileged.
No, it's. I mean, yes, maybe. Damn, how is Tyrone that actually he got? It was actually perfect response to Super.
Yeah, it was really good.
It was so perfect that I actually wonder, was it intentional or not?
I hope so. Okay, with that, I think there should be only one game left. I think like Yuki, Xe against someone.
Yuki, if you hear me, please just block Nitrate Vortex with forward move and punish it on block. It's very punishable on block unless he has RC. I don't know, but it was still. Kind of entertaining match, because how wild it was.
I mean, yes, watching newer players is always quite fun, just because they do things you not really expect, though.
Of course.
So... I think there's still one match open. I think it's Xe against someone.
I think Xe actually... Did he... Xe played against Yuki, yes?
I think so?
Or Xe
No. Xe just played against... Vladimir? See buff. We get a commentator. There was commentator. Seems we are done. They want us to play against each other.
Yeah. Do you wanna do it?
I mean, I don't care. We can.
Okay. So, are we gonna play one match or entire 5-5?
I don't know. We have to ask Zephy.
I mean, I'm up to play 2 games on someone's stream. I'm gonna say how bad I was unintentionally. Done something stupid or something like this.
Okay.
It seems you played quite a bit of Celestial.
I need sound, I need to pay him. Fuck.
Okay, let's see.
Seems I maybe it was because of me. I did. Yeah.
I mean, if not, let Xe play against Kishi. I commentated then. That makes probably more sense than both commentators playing.
Okay. I'm totally fine with that. But I need to come back.
What is...
Okay, then let me go into the spectate again.
And I'm back. I guess I'll go mute if we're gonna play like this.
Yeah, that makes sense. Okay then, we have Kishi, our Russian commentator, against Familia, against Exe with Soul. We have seen before. I don't know if Kishi has played actively after the patch, so we don't. I don't know if we're going to see the new Milia stuff. Milia got quite some improvements here, especially like what was it? Her double overhead isn't fake anymore, which really much to my annoyance because I can't get used to this and get countered for it a lot. And she has some new 214K memes, which I have died to quite recently, quite often. Okay, so coming in with the banner revolver, switching side. Milia. Pressure starting, leaves it there, respects the soul, which is probably quite a healthy decision though. Gets a 2S, didn't take the confirm, is in the corner now, has to deal with the soul corner pressure now. 2K, 2D out. Milia conversion, the standard air conversion through the wall. And with that, Mr. Axie getting a 6S there. Okay, picks up with the claw slash through the wall. That will that even kill? I think it should be. What? Okay, fell out of that super. The winger, as it's called. Neutral jump, JH gets it and takes the first round of the set. Okay. Ooh. Slides on them. Good run under. Okay, converts that. Nice conversion. I don't know if the drop at the end was intentional to reset him into the corner. If so, well done. If not, then not, I guess. Oh, 2K, 2D. Oh, 40 would get crossed up. Didn't do. Kishi decided against that. So Paceboard couples away, runs into a gun flame and an air grab. Oh, nice! 6H! Land! Reset via landing wild throw. Takes round from Kishi away. Like, if you are a Milia, you have to be really careful when pressuring souls. Like, if he has a meter and he just randomly decides to, hey, I'm gonna DP now, he's gonna take like half a hole. Oh, get C. Jumping slash, okay, goes for the empty low. Out of the. Run under. Jump air throw. Nice. With that, Exe takes the first round.
Duel one. Let's rock.
Oh, okay. Gets kicked in the face by the revolver. Another one. Oh, okay. Gets crossed up this time. Has guessed wrong on that one. Again. I was like, there's nothing. I mean, that's nothing you can really react to. You kind of have to make your mind up if you want to block high, low, left, right. And just roll with it at this point. Oh, nice conversion. I like that. Pink cancel on that. I don't think that works though. Oh, okay. Kicks him too far away. Couldn't get the Oki for that. Pace for it. Whiffed around and Kishi up in this set. Okay, gets the empty low again. No cross up. Okay. This time goes for the cross up. Exe blocking it though. Stops at some point. Did was a bit too low on the aerial button there and did fall into the Milia whatever circle. Melee conversion into the air, that would have been wall break, so that was a definite death. 1-1 between these two.
Mankind knew that they duel one. Let's rock.
Okay, oh, good try go for the aggro, but Milia can air dash twice, so did safely get away from that. JH, whip, did work. Got 5k'd on, immediately bursted away. Understandable decision, Soul can really hurt you out of that. There was no contact though, as far as I remember. Ooh, was that a Bandit Bringer? Maybe I should open the sound up again. Okay, just 6p's that. Gambled on him, going for the triple overhead, and he actually did so. So, gets the 6p, gets Wild Thread on Fafnir. Oh, moves a bit forward. Soul falling into the corner, has to deal now with the corner pressure of Milia. He just pressed close slash on him and it actually worked. Okay, after eating YSC, that's quite a bold choice though, Mr. Kishi. Still JH hitting. Ooh, jumping slash. Fafnir. Jump. Okay. Another tick throw. This time going forward. Another tick throw would have won in the game. Yeah, that would have been quite fun. Picks up with the drops the conversion with the close slash. There was no burst available, so that wasn't intentional. Okay, gets a grab. Another one. Okay, just grab it back. Actually, it's that. Oh, neutral jump. Thought he might get crossed off, and with that, Kishi now grabbing back. It's like, I can do that too. And with that, throws Xe through the wall. Okay, pin cancel. Nice! Shimmied him after the pin cancel. Well done. Okay. Another landing into throw. Really just going for those throws down.
Mankind. Duel one. Let's rock.
Okay, gets the revolver. Actually converts. I thought that would have got a cheat. Okay, didn't. Okay, trades with the anti-air and. Okay, with the JD. Brings him out. Noch a. After death, Wendel Bringer there. Kishi won back in the set. One behind, I mean. Okay. Anti-air, nice one. Why that drop though? It's like. There was no. Maybe he thought Kishi was the one with the burst. Who knows? No, blue cancel wasn't high enough, didn't get far enough with the revolver to actually convert that. Okay, wants to get out of the corner, uses burst for that, but immediately ends up in it again. Okay, Kishi decides to go for the wall break, so. Back to neutral we go. No, that's not convertible. He tried though. Okay. Pink. Ooh, that traded with her overhead. And with that, Xe takes the match. We are at what? I think 2-1 now. Yeah.
Duel one.
Okay. Eats the fast slash, bursts immediately. Xe reading that, sniffing that one out, putting him through the wall, million life support now, try to, was it a sweep or a haircut? I didn't see. Anyway, he just Nitrate Vortex, PRC into throw, an absolute Soul classic, and taking the range with that. Okay, through the wall, Batmoon as finisher, that's a wall break move.
I don't know why the Bad Moon does. Like, Bad Moon only gets one hit out as Wallbait though, and Bad Moon is one of the few moves in this game that actually have multiple hits. So it's not the optimal thing to Wallbait with, I think. I might be wrong there though. Okay. Gets. Okay, just gets a 2k sweep, red SC combo, and takes him out of that. Nothing fancy, just taking the win here. Nothing to be blamed on. Okay, solo trouble, guess strong under 50-50. I mean, it isn't even 50-50, it's like 25. Okay. Okay, just backdashed on that. Nice 6p, red cancel. Resets him with the JH. I respected the potential DP there, but I don't think that was a good idea. XC has shown to be very throw heavy, but he doesn't DP a lot with Zone, which is, I mean, at least we haven't seen it yet. Through the wall. And with that, Kishi takes the match. We should be on 2-2 now. Or 2-3, I guess. Yeah, 2-3. Okay, back to the room. What's happening here? What's going on? Kishi said he needed a short break. Okay. 2-3. In X's favor right now.
Mankind knew that they cannot change society, so instead of reflecting on themselves...
And up we go! Match number 6! The 2 slash, the jumping slash completely whiffing. Okay, just burst that away. Understandable decision here. Milia returning the favor. No, run up throw. Oh, expected the crossover once again, didn't happen. Through the wall to go. Okay, and takes him out with the Melia L combo. Bafnia round star, damn. The bolts. I like that. So, okay, backdashes, gets baited by that, gets, okay, use the burst to get up there. 2-1-4k, close slash, decides to backdash afterwards, after that whiffed. That's not something you can contest, Mr. XA. The winger, taking him through the wall, will get the LP, has to guess right now. Okay, just try to K him there to death, didn't work out. Oh, he did run into the projectile. And with that, Kishi evens it up to 3-3 now.
Mankind knew that they cannot change. Duel 1.
Okay. Game number 7. Gunflame. Sees the Milia coming down. Takes the air throw with him. A 6 slash. Okay, didn't reach completely to the wall there with the revolver, but
Maybe you needed the sectet, who knows? 6p is the 6p, gets away with it. With him. Resets with a 6s and takes the game. Fafnir owns that once again, I like that. Okay, another run under Fafnir. Power slash, okay. Seems like Exe lost his shoulder. Okay, yeah. Okay, almost has him in the corner. Neutral jump into JH, gets him though. 2k. Sweep into Meaty. Cross up. Opener. Air combo baton through the wall. Has the positive bonus now going for him. Ah, jumping slash. Yeah, that should go through the wall. Ah, has to red cancel. Into Ghost Weep into Winger. 2 meters spent on that, but it will kill, so well invested meter there. Okay, whoever wins that one will take it to set point. Okay. Gets JD'd on. Oh, 5k hits, no conversion. This time it whiffs. Gets in with the JH. Ooh, just far slashes into that 2k. I'm surprised that worked there. Because Milia's hitbox is quite flat on that one, so I would have assumed that that far slash would just go over it, but I guess not. Ah, okay. Revolver into Wild Throw. Kishi in danger and gets another air throw, taking it to his set point here. 4-3 for Exe.
Mankind knew that they. Duel 1. Let's rock.
Ah, Nightraid Vortex. Backdash Nightraid Vortex, that is. Worked. Gets him. A juicy fall slash though. Tick throw. Okay, gets the double overhead after all of the reset into wild throw. Perfect. Kishi in danger. If you lose this one, you are out. Exe taking the championship title of this ADC, I guess. Besides Vladimir though, I think he has the same amount of wins overall. Oh, okay. DP. Okay, he tried to go for jumping K on that curveball, didn't work. Ooh, okay, the fast slash, the 6 slash OTG'd there, preventing him from extending it by OTG 6H. Oh, tried to go for the thing again. And through the wall, now Exe on life support. Can he get it? Oh, that was a whole DP though. 6S, ooh! Ah! With CDP! Kishi going for the overhead. Low! Oh, didn't go for the sweep. Had to reset with the throw to get the match, and we are at potential last life on the tournament. Another one, basically. Okay, 5k start away. Did do the jumping heavy slash there a bit too high, leaving it possible for Soul to kick it out of the sky. Oh, just okay. Just leaves him in a cycle. Circle. Ah, Klaus slash hitting. Damn. Okay. Another throw. Red cancel. Does it kill? Yeah. Oh, barely. And with that, 4-4. These boys. Leaving nothing open here. Going to the last match of the set. 4-4 for these two. Oh, and gets air thrown on. And tick throw. Okay, half gone on throws. Fafnir. Okay. Wake up, Frodo. It's Kishi's. Oh, okay. Backdash that throw. Gets a fast slash. Kishi had to burst there. It's like, immediately, but he had to burst that combo, otherwise we would have been dead. Ah, okay, jumping stuff. Okay, gets STP'd on. He tried to go for the air grab again. Landed Kishi a bit too light with the punish. Oh, backdash. Gets out of the range of that 5k.
has him in the corner through the wall. Okay, whoever probably whoever gets the next conversion will kill. Gishi doesn't manage to conversion there out of a non-counter head. Goes for the haircut. Wake up super, taking it. And with that, takes the first life of Exiondas. No Exiondas potential in the last life. R2K2D. Oh, okay. Does it over? Okay. To the other side of the to the wall. That was an interesting choice with the SDP. But Milia didn't approach at all. 2K2D. Actually has him in the corner now. Oh, gets the fast slash counter hit after the fast slash non-counter hit. Through the wall, okay. Didn't have meter for super. Or just tries uses even uses the P just to get away from her. Didn't want to use that. Blue RC 5K, that was a really fucking nice blue RC from Mr. Exe there. And gets the close slash. Taking it to the last round of the last match here. Ah! Bandit. Revolver. Another one. Okay, goes further with the 5k. Okay. 2k, throw. Oh, that was a sick, all the success though from Mr. Kishi. That's very punishable though. Oh, PRC. What can you do? Bandit Bringer, Wall Stick, into a Wall Break with 6S. Has the positive bonus going, but no meter right now. Kishi spending his to, I guess, to bring him through the wall. Or will he keep the corner? Oh, what's Bandit Bringer? Okay, that was a bit too obvious, Mr. Axie, that there would be a Bandit Bringer there. Gets the close slash on him landing. Both on life support. Kishi has... Oh, gets him... Steals the corner. Steals the corner by just... not recovering exactly in it. I think Exe thought that he was safe in the corner from a cross-up. And got cross-up by having a bit of the corner left at the wall. Kishi taking it very close in a very close set. 4-5. Wait, 5-4. That way.
I'm back. It was hard.
It was fairly close, yes.
Yeah. I mean, it was quite hard. That last reset for Wildrop, I did backdash, but in I didn't punish Wildrop, it's kind of was meh. But it was... Exe Soul is quite different, honestly. He plays much more on air, and I don't really know how to play against Soul in air quite well.
You don't. You wait on the ground and 6P when he comes down.
I mean,
you're Milia.
In air. You in have quite good timings.
You have Milia close slash. You have never ever a reason to complain about someone being in the air. Milia close slash is a war crime.
I guess, maybe.
Okay. Anyway, I think that's it for today. If you want to play with us, you find our Discord link at the bottom left corner of the screen right now. You can join us. We have usually tournaments if there are enough players. We have tournaments for Guilty Gear Strive, BB Tag, Multi Blood. I think even both games right now, and Maiden Spell. And all of those are bi-weekly. So. Check them out if you want to play in them. Discord link in the bottom left. Most of the tournaments are locked to Europe though, except Guilty Gear Strive. Guilty Gear Strive is open to other regions if the connection is fine. So that's basically, if in question you get connection checked. So, thank you for our host Mr. Zephyrias for hosting this. Thank you to you Kishi for commentating with us, and thank you to myself for commentating.
Yeah, I
put myself on the back. And with that, I guess we're out for today.
Okay. Bye, everyone.